Hi, I'm Dr. Jewel Williams, one of the lead pastors of Abundant Life Worship Center, and we're located at 7701 South Exchange in Chicago, Illinois. And so I'm sharing with you, as we're going through this series, what I'm calling the glory killers. And these are the things we need to stop doing in 2019 if we want to see all of the words and the richness of the prophetic words and blessing that God has promised for this year. If we want to see that manifest in our life, there's some things that we need to do. And so I already shared two of the glory killers, which was to stop, we need to stop doing this, being opinionated, and to stop being so easily offended or holding on to offenses. And so today's glory killer is being doubtful. And that's just really having this feeling of uncertainty about something. I'm going to give you two scriptures. Matthew 14:31 says, Jesus immediately reached out and grabbed him. "You have such little faith," Jesus said. "Why did you doubt me?" And, you know, if you know what the scripture is, Peter was walking on the water, and as long as he was keeping his mind and his eye on Jesus, he walked. But then when he looked at the storm and in the water, then he began to sink. But what I appreciate is two things. First of all, Jesus reached out, grabbed him, and helped him. And I think that's important. Number one is that sometimes even when we try not to be in a place of doubt, when we do, we have a rescue. Jesus is going to reach out and grab us. But the other thing that was important is he asked him a question, "Why did you doubt me?" And I believe that that's a valid question, because I believe God asks us at times, "Why are you doubting me? Why are you doubting me?" And the question is really to do what? To make us think, why do we doubt? Well, this is some of the reasons why we doubt. First of all, we doubt because we're looking at our circumstances. If everything around you is going crazy, it's hard to hold on to what God's word says or what the prophetic word you've received. You know, if somebody told you, you know, you're going to get a good job and you're going to, you know, be able to pay off your bills, but you're broke right now and you're in bankruptcy and things are going horrible, which one is easier to believe? The one that you see. And so one of the reasons why we doubt is because it's what we're looking at. See, that's what Peter did. It was what he was looking at. He was looking at the water, and then he began to sink. And so really what God wants us to do, if we want to be able to keep the enemy from stealing the glory and stealing, taking us away from the promises, is he says we got to stop looking at what we see as our truth. It's what we're dealing with, but it's not the truth over our lives. What the truth is that we can walk with Jesus on the waters. Thank you, Jesus. We can walk with him over the situations and circumstances, because Peter did something that was unusual. It was against nature. It was against gravity. I mean, he did something in the natural that he should not have done. And God really wants us to understand is in this year, when he talks about this glory and this, he's going to give us better, it's not going to be the natural. We're going to do stuff in the supernatural that then it defies gravity. It defies logic. It defies what we naturally see. And so we have to get to this place of having this unusual faith and belief that I'm not going to look at the circumstances, but I'm going to believe what you said. And that may not be easy, but I encourage you, if you got to write them on some index cards and just keep saying the words of the Bible over yourself, your declarations of prophecies over yourself, keep declaring over yourself what God has already said, even if it does not yet look like it. Because then the question is, why do you doubt me? And I think what's important too is Peter was walking and then he sunk. He didn't sink, he didn't doubt and then sink. He trusted and then he doubted. And so God is saying, look, you've been walking with me and I've been doing stuff. You've been seeing me bring about stuff. So you have faith to walk with me this far. Don't doubt me in the middle. Don't doubt me now because it seems that the storms are rising or things seem to be going on. Keep your faith in me because I've already brought you out. I've already brought you to some places. Thank you, Jesus, that you should not have gone, but you are here. Keep your faith in me. Thank you, Jesus. That blessed me. Psalms 94:19 says, "When doubt fills my mind, your comfort gave me renewed hope and cheer." And this is really the key on how we should deal with doubt. When doubt fills my mind, in other words, it's going to come at you. There are going to be times when doubt is going to come. There's a difference between having a doubt coming and you entertaining it and staying in that place. What we have to do is when it comes, when it starts to try to fill our mind, we have to reach for the comfort we have. And what the comfort is, we have a renewed hope and cheer that comes from God. Your comfort, God will comfort us. God will be with us. He will remind us. So continue to declare the declarations over yourself. Continue to pray. Continue to seek him. Continue to ask. Continue to contend for what you are looking for. Continue to fight for and reach for what you're having, because God is going to give it to you. And so you have to find, if you find yourself doubting, seek the comfort of God to renew your hope and your strength. Don't let the devil lies make you doubt what God has said. And this year, be quick to seek God and seek the Lord when you find those cares of the world pressing in on you. Be quick. Don't dwell on them. Don't, you know, roll them over in your mind, because what will happen is you'll find yourself inviting a spirit of depression, a spirit of heaviness. But instead, you hear that stuff quickly. Speak to yourself. Declare over your mind you're going to think on the things of God. Mind, you know, if you got to lay hands on yourself and begin to prophesy over yourself, do what you need to do. Amen. Let me pray, and then I will end. But this was a good one. Don't be doubtful, or if being doubtful hits you and you feel uncertain about a thing, remember that God will give you the comfort you need. Renew your hope, because most of the time you doubt is because your hope has started to wane. But God will renew your hope, and he'll give you cheer. And then when you give your cheer, you got joy. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus that even right now, if somebody is in the place where they're doubtful and they are feeling uncertain about the place that they are, Father, I pray right now that you would remind them that you're going to reach out and grab them, just like you grabbed Peter. You grabbed him up and he did not sink. Father, I pray right now and declare that your children that are listening, that somebody here right now and listening know that they're not going to sink, that you're going to rise them up. You're going to help them. You're going to protect them. You're going to help them to be able to walk even on situations that they shouldn't have been able to walk on. You're going to give them a sure footing on places that should not have been. It should have been, you know, it was rocky, but you gave them a clear path. And so, Father, we thank you. So when doubt tries to fill our mind, we thank you, because the comfort of the Lord is going to reject it. And so, Father, help us to continue to find that comfort in your word. I hear you say the comfort is in the word. Declare the word over ourselves. Help us to declare, Father, that we are winners, that we are victorious, that you know, if something comes up against us, Father, help us to declare that you have already given us the victory. You said in your word, Father, that in Isaiah 54, that if something comes against us, it was not from you. And so, Father, we thank you. No weapons formed against us shall prosper. Father, anything that would try to bring doubt about who you are, we curse it, and we thank you today that we will walk in clarity, in wisdom, and understanding, because you will fill our minds and renew our hope. I thank you for renewed hope in somebody today. Somebody that had no hope, I thank you for renewing their hope. And I praise your name, because you are worthy of it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Until next time, may the glory of the Lord be manifested in your life.